Hello friends, in this video we are going to understand what is critical dilution rate. From the previous video we know that what is dilution rate. Dilution rate is flow rate per unit volume. Okay, flow rate divided by volume is dilution rate. Now let us understand what is critical dilution rate. So for understanding critical dilution rate, we need to understand the relationship between dilution rate and steady state biomass concentration. Okay. So this is a chemostat, this is a CSTR, continuous stirred tank reactor, and in this F is the rate at which substrate is added inside the bioreactor, and F is only the rate in which the biomass is removed from the bioreactor. Okay, so F is the rate at which substrate is added, F is the rate at which biomass is removed, which means that the volume inside the container remains constant. Okay. Now if we derive a relation with respect to change in the biomass concentration inside the bioreactor and dilution rate, we can do it by this way. So we can put an equation that rate of change in the biomass concentration inside the reactor, the rate at which the biomass concentration changes inside the reactor, is equal to the rate of production of biomass minus the rate of removal. So this is the amount which is produced, this is the amount which is produced, and this is the amount removed. So we subtract it and find out what change happened inside the bioreactor, what changed in the biomass concentration happened inside the bioreactor. Okay, so the rate of production per unit volume is mu x, the rate of removal per unit volume is dx, and the change in the biomass concentration inside the bioreactor is denoted by dx by dt. Now we know under steady state conditions dx by dt is equals to zero, or there is no change inside the biomass concentration of the bioreactor. Okay, so dx by dt is equals to zero, which means that mu x is equals to dx, which means that mu is equals to d. So this is under steady state conditions. Now we'll try to deviate the system from steady state conditions by varying the dilution rate. Okay, what we are going to do is we are going to vary the dilution rate. So let us suppose that if we decrease the dilution rate a bit, we are going to decrease the dilution rate a bit and then see what happens. So if we decrease the dilution rate, it means that the substrate inflow inside the bioreactor is going to decrease. Okay, the substrate which is inflowing inside the bioreactor is going to decrease, which means that mu is going to decrease, specific growth rate is going to decrease because of the lack of the substrate, or because of not enough substrate. Okay, because not enough substrate is inflowing inside the bioreactor, therefore the mu is going to decrease, and further the steady state biomass concentration is going to decrease. Okay, so this is what happens when the dilution rate is decreased. Okay, so after some time, as we decrease d, the mu will respectively decrease, and again a steady state is achieved where mu is equals to d. The decreased mu is equals to the decreased d. Okay, now let us understand what happens if we increase the dilution rate. So if you increase the dilution rate, the substrate inflowing inside the bioreactor is going to increase, which means that mu is going to increase, which means that steady state biomass is also going to increase. Okay, so if d increases, Sn is going to increase, then mu is going to increase, and substrate biomass concentration inside the bioreactor is also going to increase. But what level, till what level can mu increase? Obviously till mu max. Okay, the maximum specific growth rate. So if we further increase d, what will happen? Sn will further increase, but mu will reach a level which is mu max. That is the maximum level at which the specific growth rate can go, and the x will further increase. Okay, but if we further increase the dilution rate, okay, so we first increase the dilution rate, mu increased. We further increase the dilution rate, mu reached its maximum value. But what if we increase the dilution rate again? What will happen? The rate of production will remain mu max. It is not going to increase. The rate of production will remain mu max, but the dilution rate is going to increase, which means that the rate of removal is going to increase. Hence dx by dt is going to change. dx by dt is going to be negative, which means that the biomass concentration inside the bioreactor is going to, it will start decreasing. And a time will be reached when the biomass concentration inside the bioreactor is going to be zero. Okay, the biomass concentration inside the bioreactor is going to be zero because the rate of production is much lower than the rate of removal. The rate of removal is very high, but the rate of production is low. And a time will be reached when there will be no biomass inside the container. Okay, so that is, so this all happens when we increase the dilution rate more than mu max. Okay, so if we increase the dilution rate more than mu max, what will happen? A state will be reached when steady state biomass concentration will be equal to zero. And this dilution rate is known as decritical. So decritical is the dilution rate at which the biomass concentration inside the container just reaches zero. Okay, when it just reaches zero, that dilution rate is known as critical dilution rate. Okay, so now if we see, we had this formula for the dilution rate. D is equals to mu max S, which is the steady state substrate concentration, upon Ks plus S, again the steady state substrate concentration. But imagine if there is no cells inside the bioreactor, do you think substrate will be consumed? Obviously no, because the cells are consuming the substrate, and if there are no cells, no substrate will be consumed. So D critical's formula will be mu max S inflow. That is, the entire substrate which was inflown is now the steady state substrate concentration, because there is no biomass inside the bioreactor. Okay, and Ks plus Sa. So something which was here steady state substrate concentration has now become substrate inflow concentration, because the substrate is not getting utilized inside the bioreactor. So whatever substrate we are giving is getting out. Whatever substrate we are providing is getting inside the bioreactor and is coming out through the outflow. So the so the substrate concentration inside the bioreactor is going to remain the concentration of the inflow or the concentration of the outflow. So this was all about critical dilution rate. In the description of this video, I have given a few MCQs and notes as always. So please do go through those MCQs and the notes. Thank you.